Hi there, it's Sam here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do time remapping or speed ramping. This one is the slowdown speed ramp. And this is the reverse speed ramp. Alright, without further ado, let's jump right into the editing. In this example, I have already placed the clip in the timeline. This is the original clip before time remapping. So the first thing we're gonna do is to enlarge the space of the track we are going to work with. You could also be doing so by hovering the mouse cursor on the track panel and then pressing the Alt key while at the same time scrolling up your mouse wheel. Use the same shortcut to extend the timeline, but make sure you place the cursor position on the timeline. Now right-click the video clip, scroll down until you see Show Clip Keyframes. Select time remapping and select speed. Then place the placeholder in the position you want the speed to start slowing down. Press and hold the control key and click this line to make the first adjustment point. Then place the placeholder to a position where you want the slowing down to finish. Press and hold the control key and click this line again. Drag this line down to slow down the speed. I'm going to slow it down to 25%. Let's play back the video to see the speed change around this part. Then we are going to make a gradual slowdown by splitting this gauge and dragging either the right side to the right or left side to the left. And to make the slowing down even smoother, click one of the gauges and then adjust the blue handle. So do with the other part, click one of the gauges and adjust the blue handle as well. Let's play back to see how it is going. Now the gradual slowdown is much smoother. But as you might also notice that it's kinda choppy frames around this part. So if you are using Premiere Pro CC 2017 or newer, you can easily fix that using the optical flow. So to fix the choppy frames, right click the clip and then select time interpolation. And then select optical flow. But if you can't find the optical flow in your Premiere Pro because you're using the version below CC 2017, it's recommended to work with a video clip with at least 60 frames per second. This video is around 30 frames per second. It's why the choppy frames is too obvious. If you see this line turns from green to red, means that the optical flow we just added has not been applied to the preview. So we need to render the video to make it works. To do so, make sure the clip is selected, then go to the sequence menu and select render selection. Wait for the render process to finish. And now the red line turns green again. Let's give it a playback to see the result. Now the choppy frames has been fixed. That's for the slowdown speed ramping. Now we are going to make our reverse speed ramping. I will be using the same clip, so I just copy this clip and paste it here. Then I need to remove the time remapping first by right-clicking on it and then selecting remove attributes. And here I leave only the time remapping is checked and click OK. Now I want to reverse the speed start from here, so I need to cut the clip here by pressing C on the keyboard and clicking this point. And then ripple delete the other part to remove it from the timeline. So before the reverse motion, I want to slow down the speed from this part. Press and hold the control key and click the line. Split the gauge to make a gradual slowdown. Drag this part down and click one of the gauges and adjust the blue handler to make the gradual slowdown smoother. Then again, I'm going to slow down from this part as well. Let's give it a playback to see the speed changes. I think this part is too long, so I drag the line up a bit to increase the speed. Now make sure the optical flow is added to the clip. Then copy the clip. Place the playhead to the end of the clip. And press Ctrl V to paste it. Then right-click the copy, select speed duration, then tick the reverse speed checkbox. Let's give it a playback. Now the reverse motion looks good, but the frames are still choppy. So to fix it, make sure the optical flow is already added to both clips. Then highlight the clips. Go to the sequence menu and select render selection. Wait for the render process to finish. And then it will automatically give playback to the clips you just rendered. That's for the reverse speed ramping. This is the slowdown speed ramp. And this is the reverse speed ramp. That's all for this tutorial. If you like this video, hit the like button, and if you want more tutorials like this, hit the subscribe button as well. Thanks for watching this video, and see you next time.